This is a presentation of Fox Sports, Learfield IMG College, and Gator Vision. This is Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators. I'm Jeff Cardozo. It's, of course, a very unique time in the sports world, not only in the college ranks, but in the professional sports level as well. But it's always a great time to be talking Florida Gators, and we're going to do that with some awesome stories, some great guests, and have a whole lot of fun over the next hour. We're going to talk to Florida Athletic Director Scott Stricklin from FloridaGators.com. We've got Scott Carter and Chris Harry. Andy Staples, former Florida football player and now, of course, doing great things writing about sports. Matt LaPorta, one of the best to ever suit up in a Gator baseball uniform. Billy Horschel, professional golfer. And Laura Rutledge, you see her all over the place now. So let's get started with Florida Athletic Director Scott Stricklin. Scott, the swamp looks great behind you, and obviously we all hope to be in that setting soon again. And this is a really tough time, you know, to see what happened in the spring and everything that Florida had to go through.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question. You know, I often get asked what the favorite part of my job is, and I always say that the unpredictability of what's, you know, no 2 days are the same. And you never know what's going to happen. And the ultimate representation of that is they're actually competitions, right? Games, because that's what people love about sports is there's no script. You don't know how it's going to end. And there's always that tension of competition that is kind of drives what true competitors are all about. And that has been taken away. So we've gone from every day being a little different to every day being pretty much the same, and that has taken an adjustment, but we're really looking forward when we get back out there and watch the Gators compete.
And there's so many people out there trying to get everybody back to that. So, and I know you gave blood early in this process. You've done a lot of things, but I'm sure just being on campus and interacting and doing some different things and just running into all the people that are trying to get sports and UF back to go again, you have a pretty good appreciation for all of them, don't you?
There's no question. We have obviously a fantastic staff at you know, our athletic program who, you know, whether it's our coaches, whether it's our support staff, our administration, we have two groups that we try to serve, our student athletes and Gator Nation, our fans. And that comes down to relationships. And we're at a time when we're strained to try to find connections and use our ability to enhance those relationships and to interact with our student athletes. You know, we can still provide for their academic needs, and they're taking their classes online, but they also came to the University of Florida to compete among the very best athletes in the country, and they're not having that opportunity right now.
In the spring, things were going sensational, as they always do at the University of Florida. There were 8 teams in the top 10, 11 in the top 25. Of course, you know how much I love Gator baseball, number one team in the country. So that was really, really awesome to see how things were going. And I know we didn't really get to see how the season played out. And I know part of maybe the process was to get into that new stadium and into Florida Ballpark because the progress had been going so well. I look at it and I drive by and I smile. And I'm sure you probably do the same thing, knowing that when we can get back and what Sully's going to have, what the fans are going to have with that new ballpark is going to be incredible.
You know, we were on track to be able to put in a bid to not only host a regional in Gainesville, but to host it at the brand new Florida Ballpark, which we've given our fans an early sneak peek at what they have in store for them coming up in the next season, which we're planning on it being the spring of 21. So now we'll all go into 21 with it being completely new. I think it's going to be the nicest ballpark in the country when we look at all the amenities and just the aesthetics and what it's going to provide for our fans, whether it's the comfort, the shade, access. It's really going to be special.
Talk about some of those coaches and then, you know, Mary and Mouse and Mullen and Sully and Walton and Roland and Brian, Jay, like it just goes on and on. How cool is it to just get all those coaches together and know how great they are and just to pick their brain, knowing how much you love sports and being around athletics to know what's here at the University of Florida?
It's really special. And, you know, to use a baseball analogy going back there, it's kind of like having the 27 Yankees lineup at your disposal, and they're all cleanup hitters. You know, they're all so talented, they're all so accomplished. But I think what really makes them special is they all have a true appreciation for being a part of the Gators, and they understand that there's a high standard there. That when we talk about wanting to create a championship experience with integrity, that's not just something that we slap on a wall, something we try to live each and every day. It's how we interact with one another. It's how we try to do things the right way. It's the way we show respect for the game itself, for the opponents. And it's how we represent the University of Florida.
And I know you guys pride yourselves on, and all the coaches do, on getting these student athletes to graduate. The GPA is outrageous when you look at some of the numbers. So not only do you have that success on the field, but utilizing the Hawkins Center and everything that they get to do and study, it's pretty sweet to watch.
Well, that's a great point, Jeff. And we do take a lot of pride in what our athletes accomplish in the classroom and away from the playing fields and the courts. During the time of the COVID crisis, we weren't playing games, but our athletes were still, as I mentioned earlier, pursuing their academic goals, and they were still taking classes, albeit online. And there's a big-time team behind those athletes during that time, supporting them in our Hawkins Center, and our staff over there, our academic support staff over there, led by Jeff Ewan and his team. They do remarkable work, and they haven't let up during this time, and they continue to provide whether it's tutoring or just online study help of any kind, making sure athletes understand what's in front of them and assisting them in any way that's appropriate. Again, that's one of the things about the University of Florida and the athletic program. The culture here is one of rolling up your sleeve and doing what needs to be done to make the Gators better, whether that's supporting our athletes, whether that's supporting our fans, our coaches, our staff, the student body at large, our alumni base, whatever it is. Is doing whatever it takes to make the Gators a little bit better today.
Scott, thanks for working a few minutes on this this Zoom thing. It's been what we do nowadays, but you did great at it. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Jeff. Appreciate it, man. Y'all take care.
All right, we'll be right back for Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators.
Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, is brought to you by the Florida Lottery, your local Toyota dealers, ViStar Credit Union, Sunnyland, and UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators.
When COVID-19 appeared, the world had a problem, a big problem. That required big solutions from people with big ideas and even bigger hearts. COVID-19 put America on pause, but not us. Despite all it has taken from us, it hasn't shaken our spirit or dampened our resolve. We're with you, caring for patients, protecting our communities, and training the next generation. Because problem solvers don't shut down, they rise up. We are UF Health.
We welcome you back to Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators. We already got to talk to one Scott, and now we get to talk to another, Scott Carter and Chris Harry of FloridaGators.com. Guys, certainly this is a strange time. We're not getting to see active sports and be a part of those things, something we love so much here at the University of Florida, but so many great things that we get to look back on and what the 2019-2020 year was. And let's go all the way back to football, Scott, because it was a phenomenal year once again. 11 wins for this Florida football team.
Yeah, you know, 2 years under Dan Mullen, Jeff, and the Gators 21-5, two bowl wins. And just really, like you said, it's created a resurgence in really the fan base and the energy around the program. And last year, the 2019 season, you know, they came off a season when they won 10 games, and there was a lot of talk that they better that in year two, and they did. They won 11 and then went down into Miami and beat up Virginia in the Orange Bowl. It was a really just a positive season for Florida. And Dan Mullen, you know, he knew that he was going to bring a new attitude, a new offense, a renewed hope. But I don't know if a lot of people saw 21-5 in his first 26 games as Florida's coach.
Well, I want to go back to the third game of the season, Chris. Chris, and you know, we sit there and we look at that Kentucky game, and it didn't look good.
Let's give Dan Mullen credit. I mean, he came here knowing what drives Florida fans. They want to see explosiveness. And I think the biggest thing you can look at when you look at what the coaching staff has done, the quarterback play has been outstanding. It doesn't matter who's been in there. The quarterback has been a good player. What Kyle Trask did stepping into that situation, having not started a game since, I believe it was 10th grade, whenever that was, just a remarkable achievement by him and by that coaching staff. And one of the biggest things I think Dan Mullen has been able to achieve, and this is crucial, the swamp is back, gentlemen. The Gators are 13-1 at home the last 2 years. The biggest home games of the last two seasons, LSU in 2018, Auburn in 2019. Those were epic environments, the likes of which have been missing around here for a while. We all knew how important it was to get the home field advantage back, because we know what the swamp is, and certainly Dan Mullen has rejuvenated that student fan base and the overall fan base, and Saturdays at Florida Field have become something special.
Chris, this entire thing happened, and you were a part of it when the Gator basketball team, the men's team, was really about to take the floor in the SEC tournament, and we were going to find out what this team was going to be, and certainly that was a really strange time.
Yeah, obviously it was an up and down year, which in hindsight was really not that surprising, Jeff, given the fact that 8 of the players in the rotation of 9 were either sophomores or freshmen. Looking back, you know, the Gators opened the season ranked number 6 in the country and may have proved to be somewhat victims of their own expectations, especially given all that youth. But, you know, we saw some of the things they were capable of. They destroyed Auburn, which is the 4th-ranked team in the country, beating by 22 at home. A really, really big win. They're down 21 against Alabama, down 22 against Georgia, came back those games. There were some leads they let slip away, obviously the Kentucky game, which ended up being the final game of the season. But that all said, they were locks for a 4 straight NCAA tournament berth. And Mike White, this is really a shame. He fell some canceled games shy of a crack at becoming, get this, just the 4th coach in SEC history to win at least 20 games in each of his first 5 seasons in the league. He ended, of course, at 19. We didn't get a chance to see what, if any, run this team had in it, but they were playing pretty well at the end of the year. Obviously, as of this taping, you're looking back, the only rotation player we know is going to be gone this year is Kerry Blackshear Jr. Scotty Lewis has said he's coming back. He was playing the best basketball of his year. His defensive energy, absolutely infectious. He and both Keontae Johnson, first team All-SEC selection, they kind of dabbled in the underclassmen thing, but they're coming back, both of them citing unfinished business. Now, we'll know soon enough about Andrew Nembhard, but should he opt to turn pro, the Gators have a plan for the point guard position with transfer Tyree Appleby. He sat out all last season and learned the system. Trey Mann and Quez Glover will all be fighting for reps at that spot. And, of course, if Andrew comes back, you have a guy who has a chance to break some assist records if he does get back. Throw Noah Locke in the mix. You're talking about Keontae Johnson. You're talking about Andrew Nembhard. You're talking about Scotty Lewis. That's some guys who played a lot of basketball if they all come back next season.
Yeah, certainly have an opportunity to be really, really special. And there's been so many special moments. If I'm going to ask both of you, Scott, I'll go to you first. Do you feel anything like that just makes you smile from what we were able to see?
Well, you know, it was an abbreviated season, obviously, in the spring. But before that happened, I mean, there were a lot of great moments. To me, during football season, it's hard to top Hugh Ride's run in that Auburn game and hearing that crowd. The baseball team, like you talked about, 16-0 start, best in school history. You can go to the gymnastics team's SEC championship. And I'm going to, and I know Chris can probably talk about this one more, but this just came out this week due to some delays, but this probably is the moment that I'm going to remember the most. I mean, the Billy Dee night there. Chris has it too. So, yeah. I mean, that was one of the greatest nights in Gators athletics history. It was a great result for the basketball team, but it was just a special night. You guys were there. It's something that I don't think any of us will forget.
You know, I was with them the night before when they brought him and his family in for like a private viewing of the court, courtesy of Jeremy Foley and Scott Stricklin. And there was a party after, a good party, by the way. And there was, of course, that Friday night became Saturday, and it was the Vanderbilt game. And the pregame ceremony, Scott was there. I mean, Horford, Noah, Humphrey, Beal, Spates, Dorian Finney-Smith, Chris Chioza. I mean, some of those guys gave up NBA All-Star Weekend to honor their coach, which says everything that needs to be said about Billy Dee's impact on their lives and, of course, the impact on on the program in general. And of course, he demonstrated his textbook humility throughout the moment on a night the Gators jumped all over Vanderbilt. I think the score was 41-19 at halftime. And that kind of loosened things up for him to come out, and he took his bow, standing ovation. It was perfect night, perfect game, perfect weekend. And I agree, Scott, that was the highlight of the year for me.
A great moment right now, because this is what the new norm has become, these Zoom meetings and getting to talk to guys on computers and the social distancing stuff. I remember back when Spurrier had his 75th birthday, all the coaches got on there. They sang happy birthday to him. Certainly, they're not going to make American Idol or the Voice, because it didn't sound too good, but it was cool. So I know for you guys, too, and what you've been able to do and sort of tell stories and do different things through these Zoom meetings, it's really changed things, hasn't it?
Yeah, dramatically. I mean, I've had a couple of Zoom interviews here and there, as probably Chris has too, and a lot of the stories are different right now as we all kind of wait to, you know, see how things shake out when everything starts cranking up again. But yeah, it's always fun to see you, Jeff, even on Zoom, my man.
You guys were sharp as always. Again, everybody go out there, check out FloridaGators.com. Scott Carter, Chris Harry, special stuff, and they'll have plenty of features throughout the summer to keep everybody involved in Gator Nation. Thank you, guys.
Thanks, Jeff.
We'll be back with more Inside Gator Nation presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators.
You are watching Inside Gator Nation presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators.
Welcome back again to Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators. Time to talk about writing, and this guy has done it in so many great ways. Andy Staples joins the show. Many moons ago, I was running around at McKeithen Stadium throwing the ball around, and this guy was just across the way in the swamp. Student-athlete Andy Staples is now turned into a big-time writer. You see The Athletic right there behind him, and we're going to discuss all the many great memories from way back when to what he's doing now. Andy, what's up, buddy? Welcome.
Now, we have to be clear, Jeff. I was not a superstar like you were on the baseball field. I was a human tackling dummy. So when you say the swamp, it was more like the practice field, and I occasionally got to stand on the sideline in the swamp. This was a deal where, you know, I thought my football career in high school was pretty good. I thought, you know, maybe the 1AA schools that have been recruiting me, that maybe they had something going, and those big power schools that didn't offer me scholarships, maybe they were wrong. And then I walked onto the Florida football team, and I realized very quickly all those people who were doing the evaluations were correct. I was not good enough to play at Florida.
Yeah, because that was really the heyday of it all, right? In the heart there, the mid-90s of Spurrier, and certainly all those great players, athletes that had come back through. But now we're starting to see that again with Dan Mullen.
This feels like the building stage. I imagine this is what it was like in 91, 92, 93, like when Shane Matthews was running around. And you're getting to the point where you can start competing for those titles. Now, they won the SEC in 91. They won it in 93. The SEC's a different animal now than it was back then. I think, you know, everybody else is really up their game. So you see how hard it is to get to the top of the league. I mean, Dan Mullen has had a 10-win season and an 11-win season. And I thought he said it really well after the Orange Bowl when he said getting from 11 to that next step is even harder than getting from 10 to 11, and even harder from getting 4 to 10, which they did the first year. It is really tough in the SEC right now. It's interesting with Florida football being the coolest thing on campus again. I mean, it felt like for a while it wasn't like that. And that didn't feel normal to me. I'm sure it didn't feel normal to you either. But now it feels like it's sort of where it needs to be, and in the place on campus where it needs to be. And now it's just a matter of, can they take that next step? Can they compete for an SEC title? Which we all know, if you can compete for an SEC title, you can compete for a national title.
Those were fun times, and you talk about that transition of being a student athlete and getting to be around those guys and it helping you, and now evolve into getting to write for Sports Illustrated, now being a part of The Athletic, and how great that has become. So is that what you always wanted to do once the playing days were over?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And the playing days, I didn't even think they were going to keep going once I got to college. I was probably as surprised as anyone when they told me I could be on the team. So I just assumed I was already going to be moving into that spot. But I decided when I was about 12 that I wanted to be a writer. I read a book called Shoot Low Boys, They're Riding Shetland Ponies. And it was a compilation of columns by a guy named Louis Grizzard. He wrote for the Atlanta Journal-Constitution, but he had his columns syndicated all over the South in a bunch of different newspapers. And I asked my mom, I said, does this guy make any money for writing these funny stories? And she said, yeah, he makes pretty good money. I said, okay, that's what I want to do. I decided I've got to be able to have a job. I've got to be able to get some practical experience so I can get a job when I get out of college. So I decided whether I was going to keep playing football or go work for the newspaper. And, you know, I wasn't going to the NFL. So it seemed like a pretty easy decision to me that I needed to start building toward my career.
All that experience here, and I certainly owe a lot to journalism building, communications, and everything we went through. And it is really neat because nowadays you look on television, you look at you as writers, there's writers all over the country, and even just some of these Fox Sports Nets or just some of these local places, there's Gators everywhere. And the experience you've gotten
amazing
at the University of Florida, tremendous.
Yeah, I mean, the crew I was with, I was so lucky to be around some really good people. You think about, so my junior year of college, when we were out there waiting for the players to get done with practice so we could interview them, here's who was standing there. So I'm there with Andrea, her name was Shulstein back then, her name is Adelson now, she covers the ACC for ESPN. Aaron Andrews was there doing interviews for the radio station. Israel Gutierrez, who you can see on ESPN covering the NBA and on Highly Questionable and all those shows, he was there working for the Alligator with us. Jamie Eisenberg, who does fantasy sports for CBS, he was there. Jen Brown was over there playing softball. We didn't see her as much, but you know, she wound up being a TV star. So it's crazy how many good people were there at the same time, and I think that helped push all of us while we were there.
Well, Andy, you're doing tremendous work. Love reading your stuff. And you got a ring, right? So even though you weren't a part of things, you got that ring.
Got two of them, actually. Got an SEC and a national championship ring.
Well, great way to finish up. Andy, great talking to you.
Thanks, Jeff.
Plenty more to come here on Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators. We'll be right back.
This is Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health.
Welcome back to Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators. We're halfway home, a great first part of the show, but still plenty more to talk about as we will talk to a couple of UF Hall of Famers, Matt Laporta and Billy Horschel, and former Gator Lore Rutledge when we come back.
Just that College World Series experience was just phenomenal and incredible.
Laporta swings. It's a high fly ball down the left field line.
Honestly, I would not be where I am right now without Buddy. I love representing the University of Florida. I've always got some orange or blue on or some Gator logo.
When I got back into the SEC and just what that feels like, and going to Neyland, going to Bryant-Denny, going to Death Valley at LSU, it's just a different world. It is something that, it's why it really is part of the fabric of all of our beings in the South. And it's one of those things where, I hate to use a cliche, but if you know, you know.
Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, is brought to you by the Florida Lottery, your local Toyota dealers, ViStar Credit Union, Sunnyland, and UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators.
When COVID-19 appeared, the world had a problem, a big problem. That required big solutions from people with big ideas and even bigger hearts. COVID-19 put America on pause, but not us. Despite all it has taken from us, it hasn't shaken our spirit or dampened our resolve. We're with you, caring for patients, protecting our communities, and training the next generation. Because problem solvers don't shut down, they rise up. We are UF Health.
Welcome back to Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators. I'm Jeff Cardozo. I used to give up a lot of home runs. Our next guest hit a lot of home runs, the great Matt LaPorta. Matty, how are you, buddy?
I'm great, Jeff. Thanks for having me on. This is exciting. This is probably the most exciting thing I'll do all week.
You know, certainly we can look back at many different things, but of course the 2005 season was awesome. I was a part of the 98 team that won the SEC championship, and then it hadn't happened again until you guys came along there in 2005. Just talk about some of the moments on that team, and I know there's one really big one that we'll get to that really sparked a lot of things, but getting to Omaha, beating Nebraska there when it was a sea of red everywhere, had to be awesome to be a part of that.
Oh man, it was the most incredible experience I think I've had in baseball, even outside of, you know, playing in the big leagues, and probably outside of playing on the Olympic team. Just that College World Series experience was just phenomenal and incredible.
And you, of course, hit a huge homer in the College World Series over the scoreboard at the old Rosenblatt Stadium, but that's still probably not the farthest homer I've ever seen you hit. And that 98 season, some guy named Pat Burrell, who was pretty good for Miami, hit a ball off of me that still hasn't landed yet. And I'm like, man, that's the farthest ball I've ever seen hit. So luckily, you came along in Nashville and hit a pretty big homer in the 13th inning to win a game, didn't you?
Yeah, that was an amazing game. That was, I think, that game or that weekend was to win the SEC championship. And
yep. And
I had already, you know, I was leading the country in home runs, but that particular game I was struggling. Jensen Lewis had already struck me out twice with two fastballs inside. And he was pumping 96, 97 at that time. And so the count gets to full count and he's just pounding me inside. And I mean, I'm just barely fouling these balls off, barely fouling them off. And he came back in there one more time, and he left a little bit too much of the ball over the plate. And I hit that ball. I don't know, is there a basketball facility or something that's out there?
Yep.
But I hit this ball, and obviously I knew it was gone. And that was the biggest pinch job I've ever had. And I walked probably halfway to first base. And, I mean, I've got Fleetwood, one of our coaches, yelling at me from first base. I got Coach Mack yelling at me, run, run, run. And I was like, I'm savoring this moment.
I know Sully has been able to get so many of these guys to come to school here, and you watch from afar. We've gotten to do some TV games together, and I know you have a really good time doing that. But to see the arms that he's been able to do and the consistency of this program and getting to go to Omaha for now 4 of the last 5 years and all these things, because that wasn't easy to get to Omaha, but Sully has made it almost an every year occurrence. It's pretty special what he's been able to do, isn't it?
I mean, it's truly amazing and extremely fun to watch him do that and watch the teams do that. And then all the young talent that comes up, you know, the way that they're able to get the ball players is just incredible. And hats off to them, and hats off to the kids that are turning down first round money, second round money, third round money to come to University of Florida. It just goes to show you what type of program they built. And when players come to the University of Florida, they understand and know that, A, I'm going to get a shot to go to the World Series, but most importantly, I'm going to get better. I am going to get better physically, mentally, and that's overall what the objective should be for young baseball players, to get better every day.
And Sully's been able to do it, and now he's going to have the luxury of doing it with a brand-new ballpark. And, you know, I know you've driven by, you've seen it, you've seen the renderings, all the things that are happening, and we have so many great memories of McKeithen Stadium, so many awesome moments, but just to think about what that new ballpark is going to do for the recruiting and getting players here, but even the fans. I mean, there's so many great Gator baseball fans that are going to be able to sit in luxury and maybe be a part of the best ballpark in the country now.
I think people are going to want to come play at the University of Florida, A, because we're one of the best teams in the country, B, you know, it's going to have one of the best stadiums in the country. I remember when, I think it was Arkansas, who had just built a beautiful new stadium, kind of maybe my freshman year had just finished, but I know good ball players were flocking to Arkansas. I think we'll see a lot more, even more talent come to the University of Florida because of that new stadium.
And you had more homers than anybody in the country that 2005 year. So obviously a great athlete, but you're probably not even the best athlete in your family. I mean, your wife, who of course went to Florida as well, way more talented than you.
I was wondering when I was going to get that jab. Yeah. My wife, she's amazing, man. She is, she probably is, significantly better athlete than me. I'm thankful I could just hit the baseball far.
That's right.
No, she's amazing. She was a pole vaulter, All-American pole vaulter at UF, and she's really been the glue that holds our family together. She's incredible, and so fortunate to be married to her.
You still look like you can go out there and swing it, too. So I'm sure you get out there in the yard with the kids every now and then.
Oh yeah, we're throwing the ball a lot, and they're hitting it, and they love it. Daddy, can we go play catch? I mean, when we had the baseball season going on and playing, we'd go to their game, do their game, and then as soon as we get home, let's go play catch. Let's go play catch. So I'm like, all right, let's go. So we go out and do that, and we love it. We have fun.
All right. Well, we love talking to you. Really appreciate it. And we'll stay safe through all this stuff, and hopefully see you soon.
All right. Thanks, Jeff. We appreciate you guys and everything the university does for us and for everyone else. So thank you all.
Plenty of great stories still to come here on Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators.
You are watching Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators. This is Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health.
Welcome back again to Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators. One of the best on the PGA Tour joins us now. That is former Gator Billy Horschel. Not many people know the story how, Buddy was like, man, I don't even know who this guy is, or I'm not going to offer him a whole bunch of money. And then you, of course, turn into one of the best to ever do it. But let's go back and tell that story if you could.
Yeah, I was a pretty good junior golfer. Was I the best in the state? No. So obviously I wasn't the best in the country. But I could hold my own. There was some other players that were my age, that were my buddies, that were better than me, and they had some offers from UCF and FSU and a couple other places, and they wound up going there. And we're into probably October, November of my senior year of high school, and I only had really one offer, and that was to Brevard Community College. I grew up in Brevard. It was a really good junior college golf team, and I really didn't want to stay in where I grew up in Melbourne and Palm Bay. So I was like, man, I'm just looking for anything. And I worked with a former Florida golfer named Steve LaMontagne, who had called Buddy a couple years ago to just put or at least get on his radar about me. So I think Buddy had sort of kept up with what I've done, and he happened to come watch me at practice round for 9 holes at our state finals. And then we had a couple conversations on the phone, and it came down to me and another kid from Jacksonville I didn't know. And he was deciding whether really to give this book scholarship, $400 scholarship a semester, really use it or just hold on to it. And thankfully, he thought enough of me and saw something in me that I didn't see in myself at that point, and took a chance on me. And I'm thankful for that. Very grateful, because I honestly would not be where I am right now without Buddy and him taking that chance on me.
You're always on tour, probably the best looking guy, dressed, everything else, but we always see you doing that gator chomp and really representing what the orange and blue is all about.
I love representing the University of Florida. Everywhere I go, I've always got, whether it's a hat on or I'm carrying a backpack, it's pretty easy to spot me if I'm walking through an airport or anywhere else, just because I'm always got some orange or blue on or some Gator logo.
Well, and 90,000 people spotted you when you got to do two bits with your wife. I'm sure one of the coolest experiences ever. One, it was a fantastic game. Emmett's there, a whole bunch of greats are there, but to be able to do that and I guess reminisce from what you got to see in the stands from way back when, that had to be an awesome experience.
It's probably the coolest moment that I've ever had in my entire life to this point. To be able to do it with my wife, who is a UF graduate as well. She played on the women's golf team. And to be able to do it with her, to be the first husband and wife Gator graduates to do Mr. Two-Bits, such an iconic figure. It was a moment that I'm going to remember. She had a blast. We had a blast. And it was an exciting football game.
Especially what you were able to do on tour back in 2014 and getting that FedEx Cup.
Coming from a blue-collar background, you know, not having a ton of money growing up, and then the winning that amount of money is just a financial foundation to set my life and take care of the people I need to take care of. Same time, just to be able to play up to that level that I need to play to be able to win bigger events. Taking on world number one Rory McIlroy that week and playing with him the final two rounds and be able to beat him. Just a lot of confidence going forward. And at the same time, to be able to do it in Atlanta and the backyard of Bulldog territory, the Georgia Bulldogs, it was nice. And I wasn't planning on doing the Gator Chomp on 18th green. I had heard "Go Dogs" enough for 4 days. I just wanted to let them know that a Gator had come into their backyard and had come out victorious. So it was sort of a spur of the moment thing that just happened, and everyone booed, and I loved it. I think that was a respect boo, not a bad boo.
And you can't do much better with what you're doing. You know, so many great things of giving back to the community and charitable events, and you and your wife do that, and with the kids and doing plenty of things. That's got to mean a lot to you, doesn't it?
My wife and I, we help Feeding Northeast Florida. It's been six, seven years now that we've been a part of Feeding Northeast Florida over here, our local food bank, and we've donated thousands of dollars of our own money. We've raised thousands of dollars as well, and brought a lot of awareness to our local food bank and trying to help make our community food secure. So it's been a soft spot in our heart, and we're getting to a spot where we can say our Northeast Florida community, our family, is food secure.
Awesome stuff. Appreciate the time. Stay safe through all this, and can't wait to see you back out there swinging around on tour pretty soon.
Perfect. Thanks, Jeff.
Coming up next, we'll speak with former Gator Laura Rutledge on Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators.
This is Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health.
When COVID-19 appeared, the world had a problem, a big problem. That required big solutions from people with big ideas and even bigger hearts. COVID-19 put America on pause, but not us. Despite all it has taken from us, it hasn't shaken our spirit or dampened our resolve. We're with you, caring for patients, protecting our communities, and training the next generation. Because problem solvers don't shut down, they rise up. We are UF Health.
Welcome back to Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators. You get to see her all over the place on television, and now you get to see her right here in front of you. Here's Laura Rutledge. Laura, how are you? Welcome.
Thank you. I'm great. It's so great to be with you guys. And you know, the fondness of my heart always lives in Gainesville. So no matter what I'm doing and where I'm going, I'm always just so happy to be able to talk to you guys.
When you look back on that time and learning the business and understanding what this was all about, how much did being around the student athletes at Florida and getting the help at UF help you?
Oh, it was crucial. I mean, if I think back, and like, you've got to think too, the time that I was there was so valuable from the standpoint of trying to learn this business. And I'm forever thankful for that. I think for me, you know, thinking back and just all the memories, the 08 football season is one that I'll never forget. And you're right. I think the other sports too, you know, it wasn't just football, and I've got so many memories about that, but it was baseball, it was softball, it was volleyball. I mean, the very first interview that I ever did for WRUF, and really like my first interview ever, was with Mary Wise, and I was terribly nervous. I could barely even hold the recorder still, and she was so patient with me in that interview. And so I think for me, for Florida, you know, it was not only just this incredible education of learning this business and all of that, but also just making these great connections and being treated so well by so many people. There's just a lot of kindness by everybody there that I always remember so fondly.
You obviously get to be a part of now every atmosphere in the SEC, and there's so many great ones, and everywhere we go, you see what it's like to bring Florida there and the energy and the hatred for what this is. But I think that's a good thing because everybody knows how good Florida is. So now getting to do SEC Nation and being a part of all these different atmospheres, there's probably no question in your mind how legitimate, how good this league really is that Florida's a part of.
One of my first jobs was doing Big 12 sideline. So I experienced kind of the whole Big 12 world, which is great in its own right. But then eventually, and a little bit of Pac-12 as well. And then eventually, you know, came back to the SEC. And when I got back into the SEC and just what that feels like, and going to Neyland, going to Bryant-Denny, going to Death Valley at LSU, it's just a different world. It is something that I think it's why it really is part of the fabric of all of our beings in the South. And it's one of those things where I hate to use a cliche, but if you know, you know.
All of us growing up, we have our favorite professional teams. And then, of course, I get to interact with a bunch of guys that I played with, and then go to big league teams, but they're on different teams and ones you didn't root for growing up. But I think you're more of a fan of the person and the players. So you think about that, and you know, Josh, of course, makes the big leagues, and I'm sure he had Gators that he then had to go play with over the steps and making it to that next level. But the same for the NBA, and the same for what we see in the NFL. There's so many Gators everywhere.
That has been amazing for me. And I think it's cool just as a fan in general to be able to say, oh, that's our guy. You know, look at what he's doing out there. And that's been really special to watch. And there have been so many. I mean, just the other day I was hosting First Take, and we had Dante Fowler on the show. And of course, you know, in the commercial break, I'm like, go Gators. And he's like, yeah, you know, which it's just amazing to see how well all of these different athletes end up doing. And it really is something that I think to be proud of, because we're talking about not only the success that they're having at the next level, but the ways that they're giving back, the ways that they're being charitable, the ways that they're showing their personality and making us all proud, you know, as the Gator Nation in general. And that makes me very proud to watch them and be able to potentially cover them or interview them, you know, now at my job. And one of my favorites is I did an interview with Corey Brewer, and we were just talking about how much we miss, like, walking to Gator dining and all of these things that you don't think you're going to miss, you know, until you're away from it. And, sure. And he said, you know, I legitimately miss that. And he spoke to, you know, even that those basketball championship teams and their decision to come back. And obviously he and Joakim Noah and Al Horford roomed together. And they all decided, I mean, basically because they liked each other so much and they were such good friends, they said, we're going to come back. We're going to try to win a championship. It is so hard to go back to back on championships. You know, we all know that. And the fact that they did it, the fact that they made the decision to come back just because they liked each other that much and they liked Florida that much, I think really speaks to what that Gator Nation is and what that pride is all about. And that's been one of my favorite interviews of somebody who was at Florida who ended up, you know, becoming a very successful professional athlete too.
So I know how much you love Florida and how much, you know, you appreciate this university. So thanks, keep it up, and we'll talk to you again soon.
Thank you guys, go Gators.
We'll be back with more Inside Gator Nation presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators.
This is Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health. Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, is brought to you by the Florida Lottery, your local Toyota dealers, ViStar Credit Union, Sunnyland, and UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators.
We welcome you back to wrap things up here on Inside Gator Nation, presented by UF Health, the official healthcare provider of the Florida Gators. Wow, that hour sure flew by, as it always does when you're talking with friends and family of the Orange and Blue. Want to give a big thank you to all of our guests, but most importantly, thanks to you, the fans, for representing the Gator Nation so well. And remember, for all things Orange and Blue, head to FloridaGators.com. I've been your host, Jeff Cardozo. Stay safe and hope to see you soon. Go Gators!
This has been a presentation of Fox Sports, Learfield IMG College, and Gator Vision.